start. So we discuss how the scar forms, right?
Yes.
So first step is inflammation. Inflammation, angiogenesis, migration, inflammation, angiogenesis, then migration and proliferation of fibroblast, then the collagen formation, that is scar formation, then remodeling. Okay, these five steps you should not forget. Okay, if you know the mechanism, you will never forget. First there is inflammation, then new blood vessels has to be formed, then migration and proliferation of the fibroblast, then collagen is produced by the fibroblast, scar formation, then remodeling. Okay, this two is called as granulation tissue. Remember, granulation tissue means pink. Okay, pink means, remember, eosin, not females. Okay, sometimes pink means granulation tissue. Okay, it should be pink color. Understand? Should be pink color. Okay, so there are two types of wound healing, cutaneous wound repair. One is primary, other one is secondary. It is easy, brothers. For example, if you go to a doctor, his doctor is doing some surgery. What they do? They'll not put a big hole. They'll just put a incision and they will retract the tissue and they'll do something and they will close the tissue and put the suture, right? So this is called incision. This is called incision. Understand? Why in the incision they are retracting it, they are bringing back the tissue close and they are putting the suture. Why? The extent of injury they are reducing. Understand? If it is like this, it is extent of injury is more. More collagen will be formed. Understand? If they bring it back and put the suture, the extent of injury is very much less and you will get a small line of scar. Right? Small line of scar. So that is the primary union of healing. Understand? So uninfected surgical incision, okay, by surgical sutures. Even sometimes practically, if you are working in a kitchen, you get a knife cut, okay, it is like an incisional cut. Understand? It will heal with small line. Understand? Okay, next is secondary union. Secondary union is, for example, if a person got a tumor, okay, tumor. So what I do is, I will remove the tumor very deep and I am making the injury very big. Understand? I am making the injury very big. So the extent of the injury is very big. It is like a excision. Excision means removing. Okay? Removing the tissue. When you remove the tissue, what happens? More collagen forms. More collagen forms and scar is very big. When more collagen forms, the collagen will contract. So contraction is the feature of excisional injuries. Excisional injuries. Remember, it is excision. Okay. So contraction, generally the wound contracts. If I show the picture, you will understand. Okay. So this is like an incisional. Okay. So in the incisional, what happens? The blood clot forms first. Then the clot is removed by the inflammation. Then new blood vessels forms. Migration and proliferation of the fibroblast, collagen formation. Okay, then remodeling. Once again, I am telling. For example, you got a knife cut. Okay, in the knife cut, immediately what happens? Clot forms, right? Immediately clot forms. After the clot forms, they will, inflammatory cells will remove the clot and they will start the process of healing. Okay, when they start the process of healing, the first step is after inflammation. Angiogenesis, new blood vessels formation, then migration and proliferation of the fibroblast, okay, then the collagen formation, okay, then the scar tissue, then remodeling. So the angiogenesis, migration and proliferation of the fibroblast is called as granulation tissue. It's called as granulation tissue. How it should be? It should be pink in color. Okay, it should not have any other color. It should be pink, granular in appearance. Pink, granular in appearance. Okay, see, this is a excision. So a large amount of tissue has been removed. So what happens? More clot forms. Okay, more inflammation. Okay, more fibroblast. Okay, more collagen. More collagen comes, contraction. See, the wound has contraction, so there is a dip. Okay, so So this is the reason for large wound having contractions. Okay. So this is the timeline. So this is a timeline. Okay. What happens in what period of time? The once there is a wound, immediately the clot forms within 24 hours. Actually, within minutes the clot forms. The clot forms. After that, the inflammation comes. Once the inflammation comes, I told a case scenario, right? If a patient comes, I'll tell him to come after a week to see what? To see what? Not color, but to see the granulation tissue, to see the wound healing process. Understand? So, within a week, after a week, granulation tissue should be formed. Okay? So, I will inspect the injury. Okay? If the granulation tissue is not formed, then wound healing is delayed. Understand? Wound healing is delayed. Understand? There is no granulation tissue itself. It's not a color. There is no granulation tissue itself, which means the wound is delayed. Understand? Then I have to check for what is the reason for wound healing delay. It may have a vitamin C deficiency, or you may have taken steroids. Okay, steroids affects what? Okay, inhibits what? Steroid inhibits what enzyme? Phospholipase A2. Okay, when the phospholipase A2 is inhibited, whole inflammation is stopped. So if there is no inflammation, no healing. Because for a good healing, it should start with inflammation, right? So if there is no inflammation, the wound healing will be delayed. Understand? Or if the person is having diabetic, okay, if the person is having diabetic, the wound healing is delayed, because diabetic indirectly reduces the inflammation, increases the chance for infection. Okay, and if the wound gets infection, then it will not heal. Okay, these are the reasons for delayed wound healing. Understand? So inspecting the granulation tissue is very, very important. After a week, you have to see the surgical scar or surgical site to see the wound is healing or not. So if it is healing, it will have a good what tissue? Granulation tissue. It will have a very good granulation tissue. Understand? So when the wound will get full strength, it will get the strength in 70 to 80% of the strength is achieved in 3 months. Okay? So which means it will take 3 months to achieve the strength. 70 to 80%. It will take 6 months to achieve 100%. But remember, it is also depend upon the size of the wound. Okay, if the wound is so big, it takes more time. Understand? Okay. Now you all know the cells involved in inflammation, right? The cells involved in acute inflammation is neutrophil. Okay. So that is a cell immediately comes in the inflammation. So when there is a healing has to start, that neutrophil is replaced by macrophage. So the cell involved in wound healing is macrophage. Why? Because this macrophage secretes a substance which stimulates the fibroblast to proliferate. Okay? And they make new blood vessels to come. And there is a remodeling of the collagen. This all happens if there is a good number of macrophage. That macrophage should come after the inflammation. Understand? If it comes beginning of the inflammation, then it is chronic inflammation. Understand? Okay. So if there is chronic inflammation, if there is persistent stimuli, you all know it will end up with fibrosis, right? You all know it will end up with fibrosis. Now I am going to tell why it is ending with fibrosis. Because you know this chronic inflammation starts with macrophage, right? Chronic inflammation starts with macrophage and lymphocyte. They stimulate more fibroblasts to come and produce more collagen, and they reduce the remodeling. Remodeling means they stop the collagen. They degrade the collagen and shape the scar. So that is decreased. So all together increase the fibrosis. Understand? So factors influencing wound healing. Okay, factors influencing wound healing. Okay, so what are the factors influence the wound healing? The last 2%. Tell what are the factors influence wound healing? I'm asking you a question. What are the factors influence wound healing? What are the factors influence wound healing? Then? Steroids inhibits why the healing? Okay, anti-inflammatory. So you have understood everything, right? Then you shut your mouth and sit properly. Okay, don't laugh. Okay, you are disturbing someone. Understand? If you are very clever enough, don't come for the class. Right? Okay, next. The factors which influence the wound healing is vitamin C is very, very essential. Understand? Vitamin C, serious deficiency of vitamin C, severe deficiency of vitamin C is called scurvy. Okay? And it will affect the collagen synthesis. Okay? It will affect all the collagen. Understand? Even the basement membrane. Okay? So now, adequate blood supply is needed for a good wound healing. And you all know, steroid intake will suppress the inflammation. It is anti-inflammatory, inhibits wound healing. Okay? And diabetic mellitus is very, very important. Diabetic mellitus is very, very important. Nowadays, delayed wound healing in elderly people, all the doctors will suspect whether he is having diabetic or not. Okay? So, diabetic is so common, so it will inhibit the wound healing. Understand? And as usual, infection will inhibit the wound healing. So, now we are going to talk about once the healing is happened, how to protect the healing. Okay? How to protect the wound healing. First of all, the healing should not rupture. Okay? Healing should not rupture. Okay? So, and healing should not get again infected. Okay? So, these two things has to be protected. It's in the patient hand. Okay? So, they should not use that area much to get rupture and all. Okay? Because the wound healed is weak. It will get the strength 70 to 80% in 3 months. Okay? 100% achievability takes 6 months. Some wound it takes year. Okay? So, they should protect the wound. Another thing is, if there is excessive collagen formation, it is called hypertrophic scar. And if it is going beyond the level of injury, it is called keloid. Understand? So, for example, in the burns patient or chronic infection patient, they will end up with fibrosis. That will end up with wound contracture. Understand? That will end up with wound contracture. Okay, now I am summarizing the lecture. If there is an injury, okay, whether it can happen regeneration or repair or fibrosis. Okay, fibrosis happens in chronic inflammation. Now you all know why the fibrosis happens, right? Okay, so and repair scar formation happens, it's depend upon the extent of the injury and the tissue capacity to proliferate. Okay, it all depends on two factors. And regeneration happens especially in liver. It is not a regeneration, it is a compensatory growth. Okay, in the superficial injuries, regeneration happens. Okay, so the extent goes deeper, then it will end up with scar formation. But the whole organ is going for inflammation, then it will end up with fibrosis. Okay. We'll go to the practical.
Is the icon, sir, near one.